Chicago is a musical city in prohibition era Chicago. The story is a satire on corruption in the administration of criminal justice and the concept of the celebrity criminal. Chicago is Broadway's second longest running show in Broadway musical history. As of May 1st, Chicago had been produced for more than 8,500 performances. We feature Michelle Cow in a bluesy trumpet solo, Scott Butler on trombone, and various sections of the Reno Wind Symphony as we wind our way through hits from the musical Chicago, including And All That Jazz, Subwalk Tango, Roxy, and We Both Reached for the Gun. We open the second half of our on-Broadway concert with selections from the musical Chicago.
Thank you.
knows the plot, right? But just to refresh your memory, Dorothy Gale, the 12-year-old Kansas smart girl, was knocked unconscious during a tornado. She was knocked out of her house, apparently transported to the Punch Man of Oz, where she sets out on the yellow brick road leading home city to ask the Wizard of Oz to return her to Kansas. During her journey, she meets a scarecrow, a tin man, and a cowardly lion, all of whom join her, hoping to receive what they lack themselves. A brain, a heart, courage, respectively. They are pursued by the Wicked Witch of the West, who wants her dead sister's magic ruby slippers, now worn by Dorothy. At the end of the film, Dorothy finds herself back in her own bed at the farmhouse in Kansas, where her aunt tries to convince her she dreamt her adventures in Oz. Or something really, really close to that. You know, when you say it like that, it sounds pretty ridiculous, doesn't it? Really? Alright, songs featured in this medley include We're Off to See the Wizard, The Merry Old Lands of Oz, If I Only Had a Brain, Ding Dong, that's actually two different songs, The Witch is Dead, and the classic Somewhere Over the Rainbow. By the way, the tuba section is featured in one of the songs in this melody. I think it's If I Only Had a Brain. It's just a coincidence, I'm sure. And here's a random fact you may not know, but the lion's outfit or costume in the movie was actually a lion's skin. Kind of creepy, huh? Ladies and gentlemen, we should enjoy the real incident now. Welcome to the Land of Oz and the Wizard of Oz. Now, during the intermission, McIntyre talked about Dorothy's daughter who really screwed things up for her, if you remember. And Mac was talking about his dog. He said, yesterday, he said, I took my dog to the park to play frisbee with him. I said, well, that sounds like a wonderful afternoon. He said, yeah, the dog's pretty useless, though. I said, well, how so? He said, I'm going to have to get a flatter dog.
Thank you. Thank you.
Casino, Desert Wind Homes, Heritage Bank of Nevada, Jambo Music Factory, the law offices of Thomas J. Hall, Clay Financial Group, Sparks Forest, and Thunder Ann. Well, we hope you enjoyed our concert today, but before we close our program, I want to tell you that the Reno Wind Symphony has a new website. It is www.renowindsymphony.com. What a coincidence. The web address is printed in the center of your program under the photo of the Reno Wind Symphony on the two-page centerfold where you'll pardon the expression. We hope you'll visit us regularly, finding the dates of all of our regular scheduled concerts as well as photos and other interesting info. In addition, next year we are adding another concert to our season. Our first concert will be held on Thursday evening, October 27th. It is a Halloween concert. We hope you will join us as we present Monsters, Ghouls, and Ghosts So High. Matter of fact, the members of the Reno Wind Symphony will be in their Halloween costumes. Even though we've got over 5 months to go, I don't know why Mac decided to try his out today, but nevertheless, it should be pretty scary. That concert will begin at 7:30. Other concerts for the 2016-17 season include Sunday, November 6th, our Veterans Day salute, Sunday, February 19th, an American Band celebration, and Sunday, May 21st, Lord of the Rings. This year, we will have two performances of our holiday celebration, Saturday evening, December 10th at 7:30, and then the next day, Sunday afternoon, the 11th at 3 p.m. Thank you, Mac, for giving me an extra opportunity to publicly humiliate myself during that concert. Ladies and gentlemen, the Little Wind Symphony. We hope to see you back here Thursday, October 27th, 7:30, when we present Monsters, Ghouls, and Ghosts. On behalf of the Little Wind Symphony, have a pleasant good evening, a safe journey home, and an awesome summer. I never forget the thing that is to leave. Did you find your baton? I bet you'd like to tell me where I could probably help you put it, right? That's all you gave me. That's it. I'm out of pages. Unless you want to do Les Miserables. You want to do that? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do it. And it's a rock band today. Thank you.